Hi folks, Canadian Prepper here. So today I'm going to be doing an in-depth and critical review of the Survival Tab product. I'm going to be talking about what they should be relied on for and what you shouldn't rely on them for. Let's get into it. Alright, so several of us pseudo-gear reviewers have been sent these Survival Tabs as of recent, courtesy of the company, in order to test them. This has been with no strings attached and no expectations that we give them a good review or anything like that. So I first off want to thank the Survival Tab company for sending me out these samples. And just to pay it forward, I'm actually going to be giving everything away that you see here that hasn't been opened yet, which is pretty much everything except a couple packs of these, in an upcoming subscriber milestone video giveaway. So stay tuned for that. Now, that said, I still have a lot of concerns about this product that I'm going to be getting into, and it's going to be a fair review where I talk about the pros and cons of the product, what you should use it for and what you shouldn't use it for. Now, the Survival Tabs is a company that's been around since 1974, and as of recent, they're trying to rebrand themselves as more of a meal replacement, performance enhancing even, substance. If you go to their website, one of their commercials basically advertises it as something that's going to enhance your ability to do sports. Their main premise is that the Survival Tabs are more readily absorbed by your body and are more easily converted into energy. So they're promoting it as a performance enhancing thing as opposed to just something that you would store in a doomsday bunker or something to that effect. Because there is a limited market for survivalists, and they have done a lot of research on this product, and by no means there's no way that it should not gain more mass appeal. Now that said, there's certain problems with how they're marketing it and what they're claiming that it can do and what they're claiming it can't do. So I'm going to talk a bit about that today. Now the main ingredients in Survival Tabs are as follows: milk powder, sucrose, and vegetable oil. So you have your protein, your sugar, and your fats respectively. And of course, you have a combination of different vitamins and minerals, which provide you with the complete nourishment on a micronutrient level that you need for the day. However, because the recommended dose of Survival Tabs is only 2 servings, and each serving has 240 calories, so you're getting 480 calories, your macronutrient needs are not going to be fulfilled. Now, the main premise with Survival Tabs is that their food has a higher biological value than other foods. Now, what biological value is a food's ability to be absorbed by the body. So just because you read the nutritional breakdown on a particular item that you might have in your house doesn't necessarily mean that you're actually absorbing all those nutrients. It really depends on a variety of factors, some that they don't list here. But what they're saying here is that 99% of the calorie content of their Survival Tabs is utilized as energy, whereas 30 to 60% of most other foods, they don't really talk about which other foods, are not absorbed by the body. Now that can be debated on a lot of different levels. For one, it's going to depend on the type of food that you're eating. It's going to depend on your metabolic rate, your level of physical exertion, your physical health. It's going to depend on any sort of vitamin deficiency that you might have. So vitamin B, of course, and the variations of such are used to metabolize food. So if you have any sort of vitamin B deficiency, then indeed you're not going to be able to absorb all the nutrients out of your food that you probably should. Now, I think one of the best benefits of this product is that you don't have to prepare it. At any time, anywhere, you can crack it open and start eating it. It doesn't require any preparation. Of course, that brings down the palatability. That said, you don't have to prepare it. So a second benefit of the Survival Tabs is the shelf life, of course, which is 25 years. However, the company does say on their packaging that they've done tests with the Survival Tabs that were made in 1974, of which they still have some, and apparently they still are palatable and nutritious. So that's promising that it might actually last a lot longer than 25 years. Another benefit to these is that they pack down into a very small amount of space. So I think one of the Survival Tabs' main selling points is that you're getting the most calories in the least amount of space. It's got a lot of weight to it. It's got a lot of density. Lastly, the benefit of Survival Tabs is that they're easy to store. So the company suggests that you put them in a cool, dark place if you want them to last for 25 years. But they do also mention some testing they did, which showed that the temperature fluctuations didn't really affect the product that much. So that's promising if you do want to leave it outside in a boat or something like that. It may still retain some of its nutritional value for a long period of time in spite of being stored in a warm, damp place as opposed to a cool dry place, but you have to do that at your own discretion. So now for the cons of these survival tabs. So the price per calorie is way too high. There's 180 tablets in here, and each of them have about 20 calories for a combined total of 3,600 calories. This retails for about $40 in both Canada and the US. So you're paying about $1 per 100 calories. Now you compare that to the $40 that you could use to go and buy 220 kilogram bags of rice or even a big container of Mountain House. It really can't beat those in terms of the price per calorie. So that's one con. Number two is the taste. Personally, I don't like the taste too much. It is semi-palatable in small amounts, but it's certainly not palatable in large amounts. So if you did have to take more than two servings of this, that is more than 24 tablets per day, you'd probably be gagging because it tastes like flavored sand to me. But, you know, if you were hungry, you know, chances are you wouldn't care. However, the palatability of this is very low. The third con is that it's not going to give you the calories that you need in order to do work. You know, it's going to give you the calories you need in order to wait to be rescued, but not particularly to go out and expend yourself on certain tasks. So it is a survival tab. It's not for the purpose of thriving. Now, the last con that I have with these survival tabs is their marketing strategy. So I took issue with a picture that I seen on their website, which compares the survival tabs with other prepping food products. And they're comparing what they call a 15-day food supply. So the Survival Tab company refers to this right here as a 15-day food supply, okay? So that's considering you're taking only one serving a day, which of course is 12 tablets, which would be 240 calories per day. Now it's comparing that to the likes of these other items here, which actually do provide you with ample caloric needs, both micronutrients and macronutrients, although they say that it doesn't provide you with 100% of vitamins and minerals. However, it's probably going to be close to that. So I took issue that they're trying to use it as a preparedness food when really it's a survival food. There's a difference there between survival and thriving. There's a difference between not dying and maintaining your body weight. And these other foods that are marketed at, yes, at a much higher price, are actually going to provide you ample nourishment to sustain your body weight and allow you to do surplus amounts of work, whereas the survival tabs are going to basically just keep your vitals functioning. So in summary then, I don't think the survival tabs is something that should be stockpiled. I do think it has some utility if you were, say, just to take a bag of these out and throw it in your bug out bag or something like that. And, you know, they would provide you with ample amount of nutrition to get you perhaps home or to get you rescued or something to that effect. But they're definitely not something that you're going to want to store in massive amounts simply because of the palatability factor. They're going to store for a long period of time, but the fact is, they may not be that appetizing, and the price per calorie is simply too high to warrant storing these in large amounts. Now, I will say something for the meal replacement thing. I think that if you did enjoy the taste of them, which some people might, then they might be a valid meal replacement. But even with respect to that, just the amount of that you're paying per calorie, if they could get the price down, if they could half the price, it might be worth it. But right now, at this current price, I just personally don't think it's worth it to invest in it in large amounts. That said, I think, you know, having one container of survival tabs in the house, in your underground bunker, whatever, in your boat, in your cabin, would be a good idea. Once again, I want to give props to the company because it takes a lot of balls to send us out free product and let us do a review on it, having no expectations of what we do. So they are an American company. They're, you know, so if you want to support an American company, by all means, support the survival tabs. And it's a very professional company. The packaging is great. You know, you can tell that it's a quality made product with a lot of research that's went into it. It's just the price per calorie ratio isn't there. It doesn't justify it as a long-term preparedness food that you're going to want to stockpile in large amounts. So that's all I got about this topic today. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching Canadian Prepper Out. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Check out the Canadian Prepper Network blog, an excellent resource for Canadian survivalists and preppers.